Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and I thought I'd give you an update on my solar collector. It's 20 degrees outside. We've got a little over an inch of snow. Skies are sunny to partly cloudy, and I'm pulling in 80 degree air. You can probably hear that little fan in the background. That's a 7-watt computer fan pushing the air. So for 7 watts of electricity, I'm getting 80 degree air that's heating my office nicely. It's cozy in here. So, I think it works. It works good. It only works about 5 hours a day, but 5 hours a day of free heat is better than no hours a day of free heat. And on a better sunny day, I'm getting 120 degree air steady. Can't beat that. Okay, on to my next project. What I'm looking to do next is to build a rocket stove wood stove. I've seen a bunch of them on the internet, and I've had some requests from some people my design, so that's what I'm going to do. I see some things about them I think I can improve upon. Once again, my emphasis is back on insulation and getting that combustion chamber as hot as we can get it. The hotter the combustion chamber, the more efficient the stove is, the better your draft. Everything works better if we can get that temperature up somewhere between 12 and 1800 degrees. 1800 is better. So the inside of that combustion chamber, the metal is going to start to get red hot. That's really, I think, where we need to have it. I want to try to make it easier to start. Most of the comments I see on them, and there are some phenomenal stoves out there. I mean, I've got to say they're just unbelievable. Ghost just opened my door if you didn't see that. Unbelievable designs, and I really appreciate what I've seen. I want it to be self-feeding, so I can load the wood and I don't have to come back and check it on a regular basis. But still, you know, once the wood gets down, it's going to go out on its own. The other thing is, we want a design that's easy to clean, because the ashes need to fall into a pit so we can clean them out. Otherwise, the ashes are going to choke it up and shut it down, and it's only going to burn until it basically stops itself up with ashes. So those are the three things that I would like to emphasize, and I think I can do that. I've come up with some ideas for that. I've seen a lot out there where it says get your shop vacuum out and suck this stuff out. Gotta be careful. If there's one hot ember in there and you suck it into your shop vac, you're in for perhaps a fire in your shop vac. We don't want that. So insulation, easy. Keep it simple, keep it easy, everything about it. And I want to keep it cheap. Now, I have to say, I did go buy a piece of steel. It cost me about $50. I'm not going to use all of it, so maybe a third of it or something like that. That's going to be my major expense. Everything else that I'm going to use is scrap that I've had laying around, except probably the exhaust pipe. And the exhaust pipe is from my other supplies that I've already purchased. So, once again, cheap, easy. And lots of insulation to keep that combustion chamber hot. And that's what we're going to do. So, appreciate everybody watching. I really, really enjoy watching your videos. I scour the internet. If I find somebody with some good ideas, I subscribe to them and I go back to their stuff over and over again. Sometimes I watch the same video several times to try to get as much information as I can. And I really appreciate you watching my videos. And I think that this is a phenomenal source of information, this YouTube thing. So, thank you for all your views. Thank you especially for your videos. I've learned an awful lot. And there's really some phenomenal stuff out there. So if you really haven't gone out there to go digging, go digging. Go enjoy yourself. Watch a bunch of videos out there. Learn something. Some of the stuff you learn, you'll never put to practice, because you can tell it's just nuts. But on the other side of it, you know, sometimes that nuts stuff comes in handy. So, thank you very much once again. This is Kevin Bacon. Goodbye.